kinds of vessels in a house. And some are used for honorable things, and others for dishonorable things. I don't know what the word is. You see, it then goes to explain that if you want to be used as an honorable vessel, you have to cleanse yourself. So that we have a... I want you to have a picture of plates in your house. We all have dishes. Women will understand this more than men, that there are some dishes which are used for special occasions. Then there are some dishes which are used for everyday use. Yeah. I was surprised once when I came to the table here, and we had dishes that I had never seen before, and I was like, did you just buy these? And she was like, no, I haven't. They've always been inside there. But they are used for honorable things. But the complication that we face as children of the Lord is that the scripture says that if we want to be used as vessels of honor, we have to cleanse ourselves. We have learned, those who haven't been coming to the Thursday meetings, I think we have been blessed, haven't we? Those who come, have we? We have been learning that we are spirit beings. That everything that we want to do and the way that we contact God is through our spirit. We contact this world and everything that is in it through our bodies. And we have been basing this teaching on the book of 1 Thessalonians 5, about the last verses, which talk about that we need to now cleanse, and we need to deal with our spirits, we need to deal with our bodies and our souls. And we have been learning that we are a triune person, we are a spirit and soul and a body. And we've learned that because we are human, we always start with the body. We say we are a body, a soul, and a spirit. But in actual fact, we are a spirit which has got a soul and lives in a body. And we've learned that our spirits are renewed when we get born again. But our bodies and our souls are not. Therefore, we need, as that scripture says, if you want to be used as an honorable vessel, you have to cleanse yourself. We don't just get saved and become pure in our flesh. We don't get saved and become pure in our souls. We deal with the body because Paul teaches us and he says that I put under my body, I subject it to the spirit man so that I can live according to the spirit. And the reason most of the time we live defeated lives, we live lives that are, what do they call it? It's every now and then things happen in our lives. Sometimes we pray and we get answers. The other times we pray and we don't get answers. It's because we haven't learned to live in the spirit. We haven't learned to contact God through our spirit. We haven't learned that we are spirit beings. And everything that we do is based primarily on us being spirit beings as opposed to us being human beings or bodies. That if we as spirit beings, we recognize where our power is. You see, Caleb and his mate, they realized that they faced giants. But because they knew in their spirits that they had a good God, they had a powerful God, they depended more on the things that they didn't see instead of what they could see. Therefore, the scripture says, we don't live according to what we see, but we depend on the things that we don't see, because we know that the things that we see are temporal, but the things that we don't see are eternal. So in coming to see the giants, when they saw them, their flesh said, this is the situation that I can't afford to overcome. This is the situation that is going to override us. This is the situation that we are never going to get out of this as we use your lives. But their spirit says, for my God is good. And he said that I will fight your battles. It is not for you to fight, but it's for you to get the victory and to enjoy it. Because I am a spirit being. I depend on the word of God. And we learned that our minds are renewed through the word of God. See, Caleb and his men they had followed the word of God. They had seen what Moses had done. They were hearing the word of God, and their minds were changed. So as we live our lives even now today, when we see the giants, sometimes what affects us most is our mind. If it's our mind is not renewed, we start to think as our mind is. We start to think, giants, what did my mother say about giants? What did my sister say about zombies? To an extent that it affects your mind, you can't sleep because of your mind. It's a good example. It's a very good example. So my mind needs to be renewed. In that when I come to see the giant, although I see what I see, I know what's inside of me. So I can face what I see with the unseen that's in me, which overcomes the seen. For this is the power that overcomes the world, even our faith. That's what the Bible says. We overcome.